Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me on this episode of JM Plays Badly. On today's episode, we're playing Final Fantasy XIV, and we're actually going to do a little bit of the repeatable quests, the Leve Mets, and we're actually just going to level up our ninja a little bit today. So, I already know the ones I'm going to do. I'm going to do this Necrologos, Black Market Down, and a Feast in the Forest. This last one, this Woodcross Busy Deals, is actually an escort one. I'm not really a fan. The other thing I might do on my way through, there's also Grand Company Leves here. Or Leves. Maybe it's pronounced Leves. I don't know. L-E-V-E-S. Leves. Maybe it's Leves. I don't know. Leves, Leves, whatever. But I'll take on some Order of the Twin. See what we got. And then sure, why not? So there we go. We got a total of 5 levies we're gonna do. Or whatever they're called, quests. I guess we can start with this one since we're right here, so we'll start with, this is going to sting a lot. I know, at one point I'm gonna sit here. I'll do a level difficulty plus 1 just because I got my chocobo. Been keeping away from the rations is to intercept them before they get there. I'm not going to use this, but I am going to activate my Fuma Shuriken. Oh, whoops, I did too many. It's alright. Even though my chocobo's here, well, that's okay, my chocobo's in the stance I wanted anyway. One more Adamantois and one more runner. A mage running around. That was pretty good, actually. There you go. I bowed courteously, said hi. All right, let's do creature feature. That's the other Grand Company one that I had. Do that one at a plus 1 as well. You have 5 minutes to slay the 3 targets, okay. Oh, good, it respawned, but it respawned. And it was trying to chase me. Oh, and my chocobo has withdrawn from battle. Oh my goodness. I do not have time for you. I need to find my third other target before the timer runs out. Okay, it's time, but it's like as long as I kill one of each, so I can keep. But I can keep fighting until time runs out. Should actually try to remember that more often. That I am actually a rogue too. So I should actually try to sneak up on enemies. But this trick attack that you can do only seems to work when you're totally hidden anyway. So what's the difference? And it's got a 60-second cooldown. So it's not like you can use it all the time. This one's actually kind of cool though. I like this one. I like that I can just keep fighting the enemies endlessly. It's good for EXP, you get a chain bonus because you're fighting enemies. So the enemies will disappear in a second, anyway. Alright. Two down. And, let's head this way. We'll do the Necrologos. Actually, no. I'm gonna end with the Necrologos, just because that one spawns a boss. Anyway, so. I don't need this Midland Condor interfering with me, though. There we go. There's some more of them up here, but that's alright. Alright. Initiate. One above. Okay. Not bad. That was fast, actually. Let's see. I think... I'm pretty sure since I can't see it on the map, I'm going to say that Feast in the Forest is in the same spot as the Necrologos one. So, we'll just initiate Feast in the Forest and, yeah, there you go. Gotta get the stuff we need. Take a look around. Always take a look around. Look for wanted targets. For wanted targets, and I want to look for treasure chests. And since these are so spaced out, there could be treasure chests anywhere. Of course, I don't need any more vulture meat either, condor meat either, so. Alright, I didn't see anything over here. I'll stick around over here. The birds dropped their stuff all at once. The Orobon here didn't. One more to do. I gotta do the Necrologos. So basically, description I was reading, it looks like we have to find the pages scattered about, so hopefully. Oh, hey. Oh no, it's not a wanted target, it's just happens to be that there's an enemy standing here by these pages. can't do both. Like there. Because it actually looks like the enemies are in here too, so I have a feeling I have to be in there. It'd be nicer since I'm not actively doing oh hey, there's a leap bead marble. Of course. So the fate enemies are going to attack me too, because the fate spawned in roughly the same spot. There's a wanted target here. I think it's a wanted target. It's Leaf Bleed Marlboro. Who knows if that means it's a wanted target or not. It could just be a Leaf Bleed Marlboro too. Carefully pick up these parchments without alerting the other guys. Sorta. If anything, I'll just keep doing this too, because I can always just use my Aetherite to get back up to the top level here, and then I'll do this fate too if it sticks around after I beat this one. That'll be fun. Oh, okay. There must be another page of the Necrologo someplace then. Actually, for no other reason, I might just do it anyway, just because. You guys have gotten right in my way the whole time. There's the last piece, okay. And then they all come together and summon this thing. Got it. Nope. Got a bunch of this and keep doing it. There we go. Alright, so I'll just fly up here. Oh, Midgard Zamar. In his larger form. I love using Mount Roulette. Alright. Turn our two in here. There we go, got a completion bonus. Overall evaluation, difficulty, and speed of completion. A lot of EXP there. Alright. Then we'll cross the bridge. And go back to the other one and turn those in too. difficulty, speed of completion. Difficulty, speed of completion. Probably gonna level up here. Yep. And it says we've almost completed the challenge log, just levy it to me. But that doesn't necessarily mean we're gonna actually complete it, because it might have, I might have repeated a plate. Oh, nope, I guess I didn't that time. So there you go. So lots of EXP for that one. Alright. Alright. That's not too bad. I want to keep stuff relatively short for some of these videos. So, that actually does it for today's episode. If this is your first time here, hit the subscribe and notification buttons so you can stay up to date on everything I'm working on. If you're enjoying my content, you can also support the channel on Patreon. There is a link to that in the description below. There's also a link to my Twitch channel so you can be notified when I'm streaming. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.